What's up guys, this is Tectanic here and today we are going to be reviewing the AOSCP ROM 7.1.2. So let's get started. So before starting this video, I'm going to be telling you that this is the AOSCP ROM. So Lenovo K33A42, Android version 7.1.2, and you have the Android security patch level on 5th September 2017. So this is, there is no 2018 version here. So you have to wait for any update to come. And before starting, as usual, we'll be categorizing in 4 categories: performance, battery, customization, and at last the verdict. I'll tell about the bugs, so please stay tuned at last of the video. So by starting off the performance, and this is I think the only ROM I saw which can come in direct competition with the Lineage OS 15.1. Like AEX pales in comparison in between both these ROMs, and everything just works fine guys, like no bugs at all. You will have buttery smooth experience, and yes, on games it works perfect guys, like no lags. And yes, multitasking is quite good. As I open the apps here, let me open some of them, like WhatsApp and YouTube Studio. It does take some time if you clear the cache, and if you open many apps, even the screen recorder is on the background, so you will experience, I mean you can see that how powerful RAM management is. So coming to this all, everything is opening for me as of now. Like you can see here, when you'll open an app like this, so you will have some lag and I can't do anything about that. I mean, I don't know why does it happen, but it happens. So giving the performance review, this is be going to be 10 out of 10. So coming to the battery one, and yes guys, this battery is just like the AEX, which is not up to the mark. Like you can see 4 hours are left here. And if I open the screen, 1 hour 37 minutes. So you can extremely, I think you can barely get 5 to 6 hours of screen on time. Yes, and I'm using heavy. I mean, I'm going for heavy usage, Discord, PUBG Mobile, YouTube, everything. And I'm using only PUBG Mobile game because first thing, I like it so much. And second thing, that this is, I think, the most intensive game team love, which is good. So going to that, RAM management is excellent. As you can see again here, I am opening apps, but no problem whatsoever. And in the battery, and yes, the guys, charging speed is improved over the LOS. I mean Lineage OS. So don't compare with that, because this one has a faster charging speed than others. So you will have no issues whatsoever. And yeah, that's it. The battery is good, but you can't compare it with the Lineage, which is the closest to stock ROM as you can get there. So at last, coming to the customization one, and guys, this thing comes in middle of AEX and Lineage. One is customizable and one is purely stock, and this one comes somewhere in middle. Like you can see tuning, you can go for screenshot mode and take a screenshot of your view area to only focus. I hate that. And one-handed mode, this is quite handy if you have a small hand or if you want to give to your kid. Even I am a kid. So you can see here, if you slide from right side, you can get here. This is the use of, like, if you want a small screen, then it's good, but it does lag there. So in the customization, and this was the only customization, and one more, let me show you here. LED controls, battery light, battery low, charging. You can change the light of the LED color. I don't know why they installed it for karate, because it does not work. It only comes at white. And camera works pretty good. Let me show you some samples. And see here, like, depth of field is good. There is quite a bit of detail. but the picture or the background picture is overexposed, so you may have problems with that. And coming to this one, and yes guys, as you can see the tiny hairs, and this one the depth of field is good with the good effect and bokeh effect you can get here. As you can see this small plant. So this was the only one for customization, and for customization I'll be giving it out as 8 out of 10. So what is my final verdict? And before the verdict, I think I have to give some things about the bugs. So one, there is one major bug guys, that you can't use the hardware keys, you can only use this one, this on-screen navigation bar. So I don't know why it does not work. I think it may be purposely done. But if I get to the buttons one, you can't switch it. No way you can switch it. I didn't get anything, but there is not a big problem for me, but for some people it may be a major bug because this is a 5-inch screen and you can't get much of that if you play games. So it does not go so fast. It takes time to go. So in PUBG you may have problems. And another bug is Volte. Again guys, Volte sometimes it does work, and when it works perfect, and sometimes it does not work. And I forgot to say guys that there is a Substratum theme engine support, so not here, let me show you here. You can see here this is the Substratum theme engine. There are no themes found because I didn't install any of these, but it is supported there. So Substratum lovers, you can go for that. And the another problem is that you can't install Xport on this. If you do install, you will get no errors, but when you'll start, you will be getting in a boot loop. So I got in a boot loop and I was frustrated a lot, and it took me like an half an hour to back up and recover it. So don't go for install Xport. Go for the Magisk one because Magisk works here, and SuperSU also works here. And yes guys, boot animation is quite good, and boot time is pretty fast. Like compared to LineageOS, it is almost at that level. So this was my final one, bugs. And the final verdict will be it is 9 out of 10. Everything just works fine. Fingerprint is perfect. The fastest fingerprint you can get here. And everything just works fine. Even the Substratum lovers can go for it. That means this thing is customizable. And this was the only review I could give. So, and coming to the details, like what surprised me a lot about this is the how the animations are guys. Like I can't show you like this, but when this ROM came and the haptic feedback, the vibration feedback, it's excellent. I can't believe it. It will just feel like you're using an iPhone 8 or something. So that surprised me a lot when I started with this ROM. And comparing to the Lineage OS or AEX, this comes in the middle. So this is pretty much can't be comparable with those two ROMs because those two are the best ones, and this comes in the middle of them, like pure stock or fully customization, and this one is in the middle. So it's up to you that which ROM do you have. Like this has performance, this has customization, AEX has customization, and Lineage has only performance. So this one is the middle, so many people can use for this. This is the balanced one. So this was my total review guys. If you like the video, please hit the like button and click on the subscribe, and also click on the bell icon to stay tuned for my future uploads. So stay tuned and bye bye.